for the process of education? What is more important? And the third question, what is the first? The words, because always we present our, estimate the results by words, or sense. Let us start from the first problem. Surely we have a big experience, and Alexey Semyonov presented this part. Then in our country there were many achievements in teaching maths called for a light, for some people, for some students who are gifted, who are interested in mathematics. We can mention the same, and I was involved in this team with Moscow, I was in St. Petersburg, Nikolai is here, and others, for organizing the national Olympiads, because the first Olympiads were in Leningrad and in Moscow before war, that's in 30s, but this is only in last 50s and early 60s that they were organized all over the Soviet Union. Founding the popular science magazine Quant, it was exactly 1970. It was also the initiative of young mathematicians and physicists. Establishing a boarding school in our university, it was 1963. They organized four boarding schools in Novosibirsk, Moscow, Leningrad, and Kyiv. But after some time, for example, in the question of Olympiads, our team were convinced that it is not the best way. It was made like a pyramid, and more and more it was focused on the finding the most gifted for international Olympiads. It was the time that French team, André Delidic, who was the first, and immediately I was acquainted with them, he invited us to start that kangaroo was mentioned here several times. This is a poster for this year. You see, it will be, it was 2016. And it's for 26 year, and for now it's the most popular game, competition in the world, even mentioned in the book of Guinness. In our country, we achieved the figure of 2 million participants. The same thing. We started maybe with Quants and some materials for Olympiads, and now these are the books from the experience in kangaroo. Because it's not only one event in the year, it's like a direction for the work of teachers all the school year. Here you see the publications in France and in Italy of our experience in this school. These are very funny, this sea photo. And I give you not only to present myself in use, but to see the first from the left. It is our boarding school. It was really the year 63. But what is interesting, what is written on the blackboard? That's why I give these pictures. You see rotor on the left side. This is, was a school, it's ninth, ninth grade, and even there. Here, this is a vocational school. After 15 years of working maybe in this boarding school for university, our team shifted to vocational school, and our country, it was a problem how to organize the education and essentially the mathematical education in for those who really don't need it. He don't want to study mathematics. But even here, it's all, also in you see some serious content in Blackboard. And the third is in Pakistan. In Pakistan, where the government of Pakistan give many efforts to develop the level of mathematical education. Now the second topic that I mentioned. So the global maybe thought about the first. We shifted from elite to everybody. And it seems to me that here the problems in the 21st century are much more difficult than the problem how to teach math for gifted students. For the second topic, I remind you that it's about the trends between process or results. We have a very important result in our psychological school, starting maybe from Vygotsky, then to Leontief and others. Here, this is the this idea of that the humanistic approach to pedagogy must not take for its primary aim the transmission of information or the inculcation of knowledge or skill. It is individual-centric process, the meaning and purpose purpose of which is to facilitate personal growth, self-knowledge, and so on. The another idea that if conditions required for the process of unhampered personal development have been met, the individual will invariably attain positive results, though it may take time and effort. This now is a very crucial problem that in all countries, in Russia too, we see that a lot of national standards, a lot of single exams for everybody, where there are some strictly defined results. However, we see there's a main problem how to organize the process of mathematical education. We started, I think, 20 years ago to make this scheme of these parameters that are interesting in preparing the content of such work. For example, this is one of publication. It was made in here in Berlin, in Germany, in all languages, in English and German and French. And you see here productive learning in learning workshop pilot projects in Pech and St. Petersburg and Berlin. In Berlin, it was called Stadtschule. Like in New York, it was called City School. It is new type of school, and I'm sure that in 21st century we discussed here that new schools must be organized. This is a very productive and very interesting idea for everybody. And the third point about the what is the sense and where are the words? As a joke, I can give you the famous verse from Winnie the Pooh. What's the good of that, said Rabbit? Well, said Pooh, we keep looking for home and not finding it. So I thought that if we looked for this pit, we'd be sure not to find it, which would be a good thing, because that we might find something that we weren't looking for, which might be just that we were looking for, really. I don't see much sense in that, said Rabbit. No, said Pooh humbly, there is not. But there was going to be when I began it. It's just that something happened to it on the way. It seems to me that we lose the sense of our teaching mess sometimes. And maybe we don't be focused on determining the strict aims and purposes and skills. But maybe organizing something modern, something interesting, something really with a good mathematical contents, this results, this happened in our way. And in our experience, it was realized to approach to enrich, to enlarge the list of learning styles or cognitive styles, including algorithmic was always, but to make now extend to visual science, to visual thinking, to play, to combinatorial things. This I would like to put your attention at this interesting thing. It was in 1847. This is really the photo of the six first books of Euclid, of elements of Euclid, suggested by one mathematician. It's not very known. However, it was absolutely refused. It was at that time it was said that it's nothing. No words. This is exactly one of the first proposition in Euclid, the theorem about triangle, isosceles, triangle with two equal sides, then it has it two equal angles. In Arabian world in twenties and 12th century, for example, exactly this proposition, this theorem, was called arsenicum, point for the ass, for the fool, because this, like some example, if people can go over this bridge or not, because this is very difficult, really, reasoning. It's very interesting question until now, and this mathematician suggested that there are no words, only some pictures, and another. This is a picture of my textbook for the fifth grade. It's, you see something similar to that we saw before. In the middle, this is a picture of Kandinsky. This. So I would like to finish with these words taken from the report to International Educational Commission organized by European Mathematical Society, that achievements of mathematics educations across the European countries, including its national traditions and distinctions, are a universal treasure which must be understood, preserved, and developed. Thank you for your attention.